إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided. And he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jal will guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon Sayyidina Muhammad, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. The best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi al-Qur'an al-Kareem sweared by many things. One of the longest swearing in the Qur'an, Surah Wash-Shams, Wash-Shamsi wa Duhaha, والقمر إذا تلاها, by the sun and by the moon, والنهار إذا جلاها, by the day, والليل إذا يغشاها, and by the night, والسماء وما بناها, and by the skies and the one who put it up, والأرض وما طحاها, and by the earth and the one who made it for man. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَاهَا, and by the nafs, meaning the soul and the body, that in Arabic we call nafs both. وَمَا سَوَاهَا, and by the one who created it and fashioned it. All this swearing, this is the longest one in the Quran. Now what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swearing on? فَأَلْهَمْهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. About the nafs, and Allah gives it the ability to become a fajira or muttaqiyya, have fujur, disobedient, or have taqwa, obedience and righteousness. Now قَدْ أَفْلَحَ, he is indeed now the one, he is successful. Who is it? The one who زَكَّاهَا, the one who purifies it, the one who takes it into a high level of purification. When we pay zakah from our money in for charity with one rukn, one corner or one pillar of Islam, it is to purify our money. Take a portion of it and give it to the needy. So the one who purifies his soul, indeed he is successful. Or his nafs, indeed he is successful. وقد خاب, and indeed he's a loser. Who is he, Allah? The one who suffocates it. The one who push it down. See, we have the potential of being, you know, prostrated to by the angels, or being cursed and being lower than the lowest. Mean from a'la aliyin, from the highest to asfala safilin, to the lowest of the low of the lowest. So what takes us to the lowest, and how do we come to the highest? Adi Imam Ibn al-Qayyim said that what takes us on the wrong path, three issues or three avenues that take us, or one will go on the wrong path because of three issues. And he said, تعلق القلب بغير الله, the connection of the heart with something beside Allah. That is one. والغضب, and anger. And the third, والشهوات, and desires. Those are what Ibn al-Qayyim said, that these are the three. The three that you find yourself disobeying, you find yourself is somehow connected one of these avenues. So we need to be aware of them. We need to look at our heart, look at our temper, look at our desires. And all of this has to be in check. Then we are in a conscious way of purifying ourselves and knowing where the disobedience come from and where are those doors, and try to control them. تعلق القلب بغير الله, connecting the heart with something beside Allah. How? See, also Ibn Qayyim said that that one gets occupied, if one gets occupied with Allah, okay, away from himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kafahu Allahu nafsa, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of him. You connected with Allah and you're not worried about what's happening to yourself, meaning you're taking the means, but the heart is with Allah. الاشتغال بالله عن النفس, to be occupied with Allah away from yourself. كفاه الله مؤونة نفسه, Allah will take care of what his needs in this life. والاشتغال بالله عن الناس, and being occupied with getting close to Allah, being occupied with the thoughts about Allah away from the people. كفاه الله مؤونة الناس, Allah will take care of him from what he needs from people. But then, if one gets occupied with himself, away from what he should be doing, which is occupied with being occupied and thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إذا اشتغل الإنسان والعبد بين أمر نفسه عن ربه, if one gets busy with himself and away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وَكَّلَهُ لِنَفْسِهِ, Allah will leave him to himself. You are thinking about yourself, you'll be left to yourself. And if you get busy with the people, what the people think, away from what you should be doing in the path of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will leave you with the people. Go ahead. And now Allah will take himself out of this equation. You go and see what the people are going to do for you. The connection of the heart. What is the heart is connected to? Is it connected to the obedience of Allah and the comfort of oneself is not taken care of? Meaning, the one who is in the maqam al-ihsan, the level of ihsan, which is to be in a level of loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a state of love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and doing more than what you are asked. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَٰلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes those who are going in the highest level of Jannah. They were muhsineen before that. How? كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. Only a small part of the night will they sleeping. That is busy with getting close to Allah, away from what you want for yourself. Okay. Loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and wants to do what Allah loves. وَفِي أَمْوَلِهِمْ حَقٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. And in their money, in their wealth, right for those who ask and those who are deprived. And it is right, not, it's not, it's not a known right, meaning it's not zakah, it is more than the zakah. If we are busy of what the people think of us, okay, if our measure of happiness is what the people perceives us, to show, you have something and you're waiting for someone to compliment you on it, so you feel better, so you feel good. That is, you will be left alone with the people. Allah will leave you alone with the people. You're ashamed to do something that Allah has commanded us to do, so we will not be looked at as Muslims who are this, who are that, and we know what's happening in the media and so forth all over the world these days. You worry about what the people think about you, then you are comparing, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are says that you are comparing أَذَا النَّاسِ بِعَذَابِ اللَّهِ. Okay, you're comparing the harm, the bother, the people will bother you with the punishment of Allah. Which one you get? Which one do you want? You want a bother in this life, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give comfort in the heart for one who is holding on to that path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you let go with something, when we let go with something, in for the people, for the nafs, for this, because of some image or another, then no comfort of the heart or the chest will happen. Because you're leaving it for the wrong reason. But when you leave it for Allah, Allah will make it difficult for you a little bit at the beginning. To show, now, do you really mean it or not? Do you really mean it or not? And you say, I'm going to do this for sabilillah. I'm going to give this in the way of Allah. I'm going to give up what I like, this and that in the way of Allah. And we say it with our lips. You're going to go through difficulties for a while, so your intention will show. Are you going to go back to it when you are pressured? Or you're going to go through it and say, no, I really mean that. If you do go over this obstacle, that is for a short time, that is true pleasure. That is a true pleasure from Allah. Now there is sincerity in this. Isn't this what happens? What happened with the companions? The difficulty is, they claimed, they said, we believe in Allah, we believe in Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and we're going to hold on. Okay, now open the door for difficulties. Do you mean it? And they did. And we know the whole world was shown what a difference a Muslim would do in a society, in an environment. How Allah will use the Muslimin in the way of changing the world to the better. For a Muslim, I'm a non-Muslim, for an animal, for a tree, for everything around. So, our heart cannot be hooked with anything but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not with ourselves, not with others. Al-ghadab, anger, is a door that will take us on the wrong path. Because injustices, the root of it is anger. The root of it is, and justice also, the root of it is jealousy. Jealousy in Arabic, not jealousy in English, meaning the concept of it. Meaning you love something, you stand by something, and you hate for something wrong to happen in it, and you take care of it. Okay? So anger, you get angry for yourself. You get angry because you're worth more than how the people are dealing with you. You get angry because people are looking at you in a different way. You get angry because you're not deserving this. How many times we heard this? You know, do you know who you're talking to? Right? Or I deserve better than this. Or I don't belong here. or I want to a better place, and so forth. Okay, this kind of the anger, the false anger about something that is trivial, something that is insignificant, something that has nothing to do in the path of Allah. That kind of anger will take us into injustices. The description of those, the believers who are gets angry, because anger is part of us. We cannot not get angry, because we are created as a being that has innate feeling in them called anger. They can get angry. But we are going to be judging how we're going to deal with this anger, how we're going to control it. What kazimin al-ghayz, those who are muttaqeen, those who are the one who are righteous, who are conscious of Allah. When they get angry, they are kazimin al-ghayz. They suppress that, they suppress it. They see it coming, they suppress it. But they do not stop there. Okay. وَالْقَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْضِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And they are forgiving others. So you do not just control your anger, but you go beyond this to another step to forgive the others, forgive those who made you angry, forget about these issues. And then وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, another step, the one who forgives, who forgives. So you can work in yourself, hold back the anger. Okay? You can work on yourself a little more when the others are included by forgiving others. Okay, but this has to do with you. Forgiving others within yourself. Okay, I forgive this person. But in the maqam al-ihsan, to do ihsan again, the word of ihsan, to do more than what you ask, is to, wallahu yuhibbu al-muhsineen. Allah loves those who are muhsineen, those who are doing extra, those who are not just suppressing their anger, not those who are not just suppressing and forgiving, but those who are suppressing, forgiving, and doing something good for those who got them angry. That is a whole different level. Okay? So this anger that takes us on the wrong path can actually be used to take us to the best of paths, which is the path of ihsan. The path that takes us to the highest places in Jannah. And then the shahawat, then desires, the third door, the door of desires. Zuyyina lil-nas. It was beautified for people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Zuyyina lil-nas. Hubbu shahawat, the love of desires. من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة والخيل المسومة والأنعام والحرث. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, what is it that mankind has a desire for? النساء, women. والبنين, progeny, children, having more children and having a clan, if you will. والقناطير المقنطرة, and the tons of الذهب والفضة, gold and silver. والخيل المسومة, the pedigree of خيل, of horses. والأنعام, cattle. والحرث, land, that you can till the land and you own land and so forth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that mata' الحياة الدنيا, that is the mata' of this dunya. This is the mata' of this lower life. This is the pleasure of this lower life. وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حُسْنُ الْمَآبِ. With Allah is the best of going, the best of abode, the best of going back, the best of end is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That desire, how are we controlling it? When Yusuf alayhi salam, Joseph Yusuf alayhi salam, the son of Yaqub, of Isaac alayhi salam, when he was seduced by the woman that he was a slave in their house, and what did he say? As soon as he felt his desire and so forth, Ma'adha Allah, innahu Rabbi, ahsana mathwaya, innahu la yuflihu al-zalimun. Three things. Ma'adha Allah, remember Allah immediately. Ma'adha Allah, astaghfirullah. Ma'adha Allah, I seek refuge in Allah, running to Allah immediately. إِنَّهُ رَبِّي أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايَ. One of these tafsiri explanation that he is a man who took care of me, meaning her husband. This household, he's, even though he's a slave, but he appreciated how well he was being treated and so forth. Or it's talking إِنَّهُ رَبِّي, meaning Allah is my Lord. Not the man that is in his house is Lord, meaning Lord of the house, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of me. إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ. That those who are unjust will not reach success. Success will not come to those who are ظالمون, who are unjust. So this committing adultery, committing a sin, committing fornication, following the desires is committing injustice. Then Adam alayhi salam and his wife in Jannah, when they were called to come to close to the tree, when they are told not to get near it, when they got near it and ate from it, as soon as they ate, they said, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. Our Lord, we committed injustice to ourselves. They knew the injustice. So that door of shahawat, once it is open, it has steps. See, the shahwa, the desire, does not take you from 1 to 10. It takes you from 1 to 2, from 2 to 3, from 3 to 4, until you get to 10. So this path and these steps of shaitan, the first step is just like the last step. The first step is as haram, unlawful, as the last step. You're taking steps toward 10, number 10 from number 1, and number 10 is the actual action of sin. That step number 1 is haram. But you can get back to step 0, to step out of that path, and it is easy from 1 to 0. But if you go to the second one, it's going to be difficult to come back. If you go to the third, it's going to be very difficult. Now we're going to go to 10. You're going to have, maybe you're going to need a surgery then. You're going to need something drastic. You're going to need a lot of work. That's why a Muslim is a person who is alert. Alert. Constantly alert about those three doors. Always alert about these three doors. When they see one of them start to squeak open a little bit, runs to it, try to shut it. Are we angels? No. Do we open doors and step out of it? Yes, we do. But the one who is a believer, the one who remembers and come back in right away, does not wait outside of the door for a longer period of time. The longer we wait, the more diseases we're going to have. The heart, our heart will harden. So the doors are there. The doors of connecting the heart with something beside Allah. The door of anger, envy, and more and more and more that goes into this, that will take us to commit what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us is haram. It is unlawful. It is unacceptable. Then the desire, the door of desire, that is the most dangerous. Well, it is the easiest to go in is that door, especially with our youth, with our young ones, with the one who's living within a society that go through all these three doors with no problem at all. But some of us, in our own home, in our own environment, we open these doors for our children to look at and step out of it and so forth. We are showing our children step 1 and tell them don't go on it. And show them step 2, 3, 4, show them step 10 and say, see, this step 10 is haram. If we open our eyes to that which is unlawful, it's easier to fall into it. If we open our mind to that which is unlawful, before you're ready to Deal with it. You're falling right into it. We have youth who are read a couple of books, sat in a couple of halaqat. They think they are scholars now. They go on the internet, they say, I can debate with anybody. Okay? And they go into sites and talk to people who are putting doubts in the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, putting doubts in Islam, putting doubts in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and so forth. And he goes, I can deal with this, and faces the fitan that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us. When you see the fitan, don't be so big like that and go and say, I can deal with it. No, stay away from it. So they go in it and they fall in it and they come running. You know, I was on the internet and somebody this and that. Is that true? What is this and that? Doubt in the very root of the religion. He does not know what to deal with it because he's not ready. Yes, the doors, we have to work in not opening the doors with ourselves. But our family, we are responsible for them. And our community, we are responsible to one another to advise ourselves of not opening the door and how to shut these doors. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فادعوا ويستجب لكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about those who are believers, those who are muttaqeen, those who are mu'mineen, الَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ, those who do not call with Allah any deity, meaning to call on only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they're making dua, supplications, when they ask, when they are in need, ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق. They do not take life, okay, that Allah made haram, made unlawful to take life, meaning to kill, except بالحق, except with the rights, meaning a life for a life, and it's not for an individual to do that. They are not doing so. ولا يزنون, and they do not commit zina, they do not commit adultery. Here is the Allah describe those, the three doors in this ayah, as Ibn Qayyim said, that here are the three doors in this ayah. There is three paths in this ayah. The ayah saying that, and they are the one, meaning the believer, they are, do not call anyone beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the door of ta'alluq al-qalb bighayri Allah. The door of the heart is not connected with anything except Allah. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ, and they do not kill. And he was saying that killing, that is the ultimate of anger. Anger will take you to that point of killing. And then وَلَا يَزْنُونَ, that is shahawat, that is desire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, protect our children, protect our community, protect the Muslimin and Muslimat from the work of shayateen and work of our nafs and our desires. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the right path and help us and give us the energy and take us and help us to be on it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the wrong path and help us to be able not to go on it. Allahumma anta a'lamu bima fi qulubina faghfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma anta a'lamu bihajatina minna faqdiha lana. اللهم أنت أعلم بسرنا وعلى نيتنا فتقبل معذرتنا وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وقوموا إلى الصلاة رحمكم الله.